which we have tried to work around that is to create a very small but dedicated group within the police force that just looks at this. So for them, this is priority. They are not concerned with what else is happening. This is one way, it's not the only way. We worked very, very closely, for example, with the Mumbai police in creating a cybercrime lab, where not only is there a small dedicated group in the police force who is fully aware and educated about aspects related to the laws and infringement of law in this area, but where they've got so-called cyber-forensics, where they can know how to collect evidence, how to retain evidence, just as they're experts in knowing that you go to the scene of a crime, you dust it for fingerprints and collect whatever clues you can. The same kind of thing here. Also in terms of preserving data, so you don't erase the hard disk or punch the floppy and put it in the file saying this is evidence. So, you know, we're trying to get beyond that. And we've had some good, excellent response from the Mumbai police. We bring that as a sort of pilot and then we'd like to roll that out to the rest of the country. And in doing all this, I come back to the point of saying that we need to, one, educate these people about the law and the legal framework, and two, make sure that that legal framework is not like the seal, it's not leaky, that it is enforceable, that people don't get away by doing something. And I think that's where the kind of effort which Mr. Dugal has taken in putting together a book which can be used by the enforcement agency, by lawyers, and equally importantly by us in industry who have to, you know, sign contracts, find out what needs to be done, how to do something. This kind of book I hope will serve almost like a manual for those in the industry. Because one important part of this assurance to our end customers is also the contract. The contract has to be something which they feel comfortable with, that takes care of the laws of the land. And the laws of the land mean that potence, because the work is being executed here, but it's been executed for somebody or for some entity that is abroad. So you've got to make sure how you look at this in terms of international law and where it goes. And that's the kind of thing I hope that Mr. Dugal's book will help us to see through, to create better understanding in the industry about what is it that we need to look for, what kind of contractual obligations, how do you look into what laws exist in India and abroad, and finally, you know, what changes are required in these laws. And I look forward to being able to use this book, Mr. Dugal, with both industry and as we roll out workshops with the police and the judiciary to be able to get them on board with us. And most of all, I look for more lawyers who will help us with this. You know, one thing that all laws do is to make enrich the legal community, and the government often helps in that. I tell my friends in government that every now and again, they put out a circular, the main purpose of which is not to collect more tax from industry or for the government revenues to go up, but for the lawyers to do that is better. But I think in this particular area at least, we are delighted that this is happening, because it is a point of some concern. And the very fact that we are proactively doing work like this creates a very good impact on customers outside. They know that not only are there laws, but there is an active legal community that's actively engaged with looking at these laws and seeing what they need to do. And when lawyers talk to each other, I think they talk the same language. And I think if people like Mr. Dugal can take more interest in looking at this whole aspect of things that are outsourced, it's a new kind of thing that's happening worldwide, of data moving and what needs to be done to protect it as it moves across national boundaries, what kind of laws, what security, what comfort levels, I'm sure it's going to be very helpful. So once again, Mr. Dugal, congratulations. We are delighted this book is here. I think I speak on behalf of all of industry, the whole IT industry, when I say that we are really happy with this initiative. We think it will be a great help. We look forward to continuing to work with you and your colleagues from the legal community to make sure that the legal framework in India is strong and stronger, and that the IT industry, which has done so well, and the BPO part in particular, which is really on fire, is booming, continues to go ahead as vigorously as it has done in the past. Thank you.
Mr. Gandhi, for sharing such important facts and issues, especially legal issues about the BPO industry in India and what needs to be done. I would now like to invite everyone for a cup of tea, and we would reassemble at 10:45 for the day-long seminar that is to be conducted by Mr. Pavan Kapoor. Thank you, everyone.
Good. So then the whole thing. No, I know, I understand the perspective.